The next paper comes from Hannover and from Lüneburg, and I'm really delighted to see that Matthias Schmidt, he used to be a very active research affiliate in the community of CRP. He's now a professor in Lüneburg, and together with Janine Meyer and Lasse Hertel, he has submitted a paper which is entitled Data-Based Root Cause Analysis for Improving Logistic Key Performance Indicators of a Company's Internal Supply Chain. We are really looking forward to see that presentation and Matthias Schmidt here. Thank you.
Hello everybody, this is Matthias Schmidt speaking from the Institute of Product and Process Innovation of the Leuphana University of Lüneburg in Germany. My talk today is about data-based root cause analysis for improving logistic key performance indicators of a company's internal supply chain. The presentation today is structured as follows. I would like to start with a short motivation. Then I will show you cause-effect relation trees, or one tree as a major element of our approach. Then I would like to go a little more into detail, showing you a case study in industrial practice. And I would like to close my presentation with a short conclusion. So if we look at the company's internal supply chain, we see here a generic internal supply chain of a company with five components or five core processes, which are the procurement, the preliminary production stage, the interim storage, the end production stage, and the dispatch. And from a logistic point of view, there are several key performance indicators for each of this core process. Looking at the dispatch, for example, we have the finished goods store, representing the logistics costs, and we have the delivery capability, the due date compliance, the delivery time, and the service level, representing logistics output. Looking at the end production stage, we have the schedule reliability and the throughput time for the logistics output, and the utilization and the work in process for the logistics costs. Now, if companies do not achieve their targets, looking at these logistic KPIs of the core processes of a company's internal supply chain, companies have to seek for the reasons, for the real reasons for not achieving their targets regarding the logistic key performance indicators of the core processes. When you now have a look into the companies, often give you specific statements what they think about the reasons. Here I would like to present you some of these statements out of several industrial projects where companies did not achieve the targets regarding logistic KPIs. If we want to meet the deadline and get delivery time problems under control, we have to expand our capacities. Yes, it might for sure be a useful measure, but expensive one as well. Despite high stocks, adherence to delivery dates is low. Okay, so high stocks are bad, but not beneficial in this case. The logistic costs are too high, generally. The turnover rate of products is too low. Long delivery times mainly result from customer behavior. So industrial companies are confronted with a wide range of problems, and the challenge is to determine the root causes and elect the right measures for improving the logistic KPIs. We developed one approach with the cause-effect relation tree as one major element. Looking at the literature, there are several approaches existing which tend similar problems. For example, we have the value stream analysis, a very beneficial tool. This tool has its advantages in a one product manufacturing processes, and it's there are some weaknesses when you have cross-linked material flows, so very complex material flows. They can hardly be visualized and hardly be analyzed using value stream analysis. On the other hand, we have a simulation as another approach. You have very beneficial results, very strong results out of a simulation study, but to create a simulation model needs a very high workload and a very high effort, and doing the simulation study as well. And you need a quite expert knowledge, quite high expert knowledge to create the simulation model and to do the simulation study. So we developed another approach with a model-based cost trees for logistic KPIs in the company's internal supply chain. So we considered all the KPIs shown on slide 4 and in the earlier part of the presentation for the 5 core processes: procurement, volume reduction stage, interim storage and production stage, and dispatch. And we worked out what might be reason for not achieving the targets regarding to the logistic KPIs. For example, here we have the schedule reliability. Now, if a company has a low schedule reliability, on the first level, there are 3 possible reasons. The first one is a sequence deviation. The second one is a backlog. And the third one is input deviation. Now, if the backlog is the reason, you can go one level deeper into this cause-effect relation tree and find out what is the reason for the backlog, and so on and so forth. So these trees normally go up to the third or the fourth level, and then you have the real reason for a low schedule reliability. But how to find the right path within this cause-effect relation tree, that requires additionally data analyzation. So with the development of model-based cause-effect trees, the root causes can be identified in combination with a data analysis and the right measures, right countermeasures to improve the logistic KPIs can be derived and can be selected. I would like to go a little more into detail, showing you a case study. Here on this slide, you can see the generic supply chain, internal supply chain of a molding tool manufacturer. The first core process, we have the procurement, then we have the preliminary production stage. In this case, this is a machine shop with about 50 work systems and 6,800 orders a year. Then we have the interim storage, and then we have the end production stage. In this case, this is an assembly line where the products are finished. In the upper part of the slide, you can see the output deviation of the machine shop. So you can see the deviation is very broad, with a standard deviation of about 20 days. And the resulting schedule reliability is only about 60%. So only 60% of the orders out of the machine shop reach the assembly line in time. So almost no finished product will reach the customer in time. So the company has to improve the schedule reliability. But what will be the right measures to improve the schedule reliability, and what are the real reasons for the low schedule reliability? So now we have a look at our cause-effect trees and combine it with a data analysis. So the first reason might be the backlog. The backlog can occur because of a constant backlog or because of a wiring backlog. If you have a constant backlog, reasons might be faulty scheduling, frequent technical organizational disruptions or quality issues, or workload higher than the maximum capacity. A wiring output rate and a constant input rate, or a wiring workload at a constant output rate, might be reasons for a wiring backlog. But is the backlog the reason? So let's have a look at the data. Here we see the backlog given a number of production orders over a time period. On the x-axis we can see the weeks of 1 year. So the period of consideration is 1 year. And we can see the fluctuations of the backlog. The backlog starts with a zero production orders, and then it rises up to 100 and up to 125, 130 production orders. Then it decreases again, and we have a negative backlog at the week 101, and then it rises again up to 100, and so on and so forth. So we have a significant variation in the total backlog, but it is relevant. Remember that we have a machine shop with 6,800 orders a year. We're considering 220 working days in a year. That means we have about round about 30 orders a day. So if we have a backlog of, let's say, 120 orders, like in week 78, for example, that means that the resulting backlog is, resulting lateness is 4 days. So once again, looking at the output deviation, where we have a standard deviation of 20 days and orders more than 30 days too late, the 4 days lateness residing of the backlog is not the main reason. It's a minor reason, but not the main reason. So backlog is not the real problem. So let's have a look at the input deviation. The input deviation might occur because of an unpunctual start of production or missing material. We had a look at the storage, at the an incoming goods storage, and the materials were on stock, and we had no problems with the supply of faulty or wrong materials, or with problems with the low schedule reliability of upstream processes. But we had an unpunctual start of production, which might occur because of low schedule reliability of upstream processes, unpunctual order release, or unrealistic scheduling. Here we see the input deviation, and you can see that in mean the orders are started 10 days too early. So we had a closer look at the data, and the data says that there's almost all orders are started with one machine, with one working system, which is a saw. And this saw starts the orders up to 60 or 70 days too early without permission. So this is the reason, one reason for the low schedule reliability. The orders started too late, were started too late because the construction department has not finished its work. So we had capacity problems within the construction department. So these were two real reasons, and two main reasons where countermeasures have to work on. The third reason might be the sequent deviation. This I would like to show you quite quick. Reason for a sequence deviation is a faulty scheduling, frequently technical organization disruptions or quality issues, unsuitable order prioritization, or unsuitable sequencing rules. Here we can see the relative output deviation, which is the difference between the planned and the actual throughput time. And we can see there's a significant variation and deviation of the relative output. But when we have a look at the relationship between the relative schedule duration and between the input deviation, we can see that orders which are started too early, for example, on the left part of the curve, 80 days too early, that these orders are slowed down when they run through the production. Though what people try to do is to speed up orders started too early and to slow down orders which are started too early, and speed up orders, sorry, which are started too late. So there's no main reasons within the relative schedule duration. They only try to work on the problem out of the input deviation. So what are the proposed counteractive measures? First, release orders on the planned starting date and not too early. Qualify employees regarding double machine controlling and raise their awareness of the negative consequences of local optimization. Provide replacements in case of sickness. increase the capacity, flexibility, and reorganize the workload of the construction processes within the construction department. Use performance-oriented sequencing with consideration of the planned date for each operation process, and focus on backlog when using flexible working hours. So we considered the minor problems as well, but for sure the company focus on the major problems presented within this presentation. So I'd like to conclude. We developed a systematic analysis that can help to identify possible causes of insufficient logistic KPIs. So now continuously comparing of logistic KPIs and applying the presented root cause analysis can be used to establish a permanent control tool to implement permanent control loops. And further research is planned to combine the approach with other methods such like simulation, for example. So with this, I'd like to close the presentation. I thank you very much for your attention, and I'm ready to answer any questions. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Matthias, for doing the presentation and the paper. We're trying to get him live now on the stream. Matthias, hi, can you hear us?
I can hear very well.
Thank you very much for joining us and for doing the paper and the presentation. The question that I'd like to discuss with you is about the complexity of the method. The implementation in companies, especially the continuous execution of the method, seems to be tied to a lot of effort. Can you comment on that, how that can be implemented?
Yeah. First of all, hi everybody, it's a pleasure to be here, and thank you for all your effort hosting this session. You're perfectly right. When you do all this analyzation, you need some expert knowledge. You need to know which analyzation to make in which case, and you need to collect all the data, and you need to prepare the data and do the analyzation. And it's some effort. For example, in this case, I needed about 5 days, working days, to do all the analyzation and to prepare the presentations to the customer. So now it is quite a high effort, yes.
Yes. So can you comment on how that scales with the size of the company? So for small enterprises or for large enterprises?
Yeah. If you do the analyzation without structuring software, but with single additional analyzations, the effort arises with the size of the company. So here we analyzed a two-stage manufacturing company with a manufacturing stage in the first case, and a final assembly as a second stage. If you have more production areas, the effort increases with the number of the production areas.
Okay, so can you briefly at the end maybe, do you have a success story for us as a last question?
Yes, it is not beneficial for sure for companies to do these high effort analyzations. So we founded a startup where we implemented a software to do all the analyzation in an automated way, to be able to have a continuous control of the logistic KPIs and to analyze and define the right measures to improve the situation. We have some contracts with different companies up to now, so that's quite a success for us.
Oh, thanks. That's very, very good to know, and all the best for your future success with
thanks
that method.
A lot.
So it's very good to see that research being used in practice now. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much. Goodbye, Professor Matthias Schmidt from Lüneburg.
Thanks a lot. Have a nice day. Bye.
Goodbye. So that was the paper presentation for the paper entitled Data-Based Root Cause Analysis for Improving Logistic Key Performance Indicators of a Company's Internal Supply Chain, authored by Matthias Schmidt, Janine Meyer and Lasse Hertel, affiliated to the University of Lüneburg and the University of Hanover.